Verizon buys AOL, a $500 waterproof drone that follows you around like a puppy, and Facebook for people who make things. Tech News Tonight is next.
This is TWiT.
This is Tech News Tonight, episode 336 for Tuesday, May 12th, 2015. This episode of Tech News Tonight is brought to you by Dropbox for Business. Dropbox for Business lets your team sync and share files just like Dropbox. Take advantage of the existing usage and familiarity of Dropbox and don't waste time trying to find a different solution. Visit dropbox.com/twit for a free 14-day trial. That's dropbox.com/twit. Welcome. I am Megan Maroney. It's just me and you today, so let's get to today's big news. Your great aunt Myrtle, who still has her AOL email address, might know more about this business than you think. Today, Verizon announced their acquisition of AOL in a deal worth $4.4 billion. AOL, of course, is more than just Myrtle's gateway to the internet. They own TechCrunch and Engadget and the Huffington Post. Should our friends at those tech news outlets be worried? Kara Swisher at Recode says maybe some of them. A number of sources claim that AOL has been in discussions to spin off the Huffington Post. TechCrunch and Engadget appear to be fine, but that is not why Verizon is paying the big bucks for AOL. Forbes reports that the deal would give the world's second largest mobile carrier access to AOL's highly lucrative technology for placing online ads. In a memo to employees, AOL CEO Tim Armstrong was upbeat about the company's future. He writes, mobile will represent 80% of consumers' media consumption in the coming years, and if we are going to lead, we need to lead in mobile. And in case you're planning on conducting some super secret business on Google Hangouts, don't. Motherboard says that Google has admitted that Hangouts does not include end-to-end encryption. This means that it's technically possible for the feds to wiretap your not-so-private Google Hangouts. It's possible, but not necessarily probable. According to Google's 2013 transparency report, the company only had 19 government wiretap requests, and they didn't specify how many or if any of those were Google Hangouts. Attention, 25-year-old men, your GoPro videos are about to get even more awesome. A company called Lily Robotics has just announced a camera-equipped drone that you can throw up in the air, and it will follow you wherever you go for the next 20 minutes before the battery runs out. The Lily drone is also waterproof, which you know from watching this show is a key feature in drones, unless, of course, you want to make your living off your YouTube video of yourself narrowly catching your drone before it plunges into a body of water. Lily is controlled by your wrist-worn controller that also records the audio. Right now, it's only $499 if you pre-order it. That's $499. Or you can wait and pay $999 if you order it after its release in early 2016. Coming up, the first Apple Watch app from Google has landed, and one company will give you ice cream for protecting the world from asteroids. But first, many of you use Dropbox. We do too. And at TWiT, we use it to sync and share files, everything from sharing audio MP3s, large graphic files, invoices, program schedules. I use it for this very show for big images and videos. And so do people in over 4 million businesses throughout the world. Grow your business. Dropbox for Business is a better way to manage accounts, manage billing, and have visibility and control over your data. Dropbox for Business lets you do just that, and you don't have to waste time finding a different solution. What is Dropbox for Business? It's the same easy Dropbox experience your employees already love and trust, which means less training and more productivity. Simple storage and sharing for any type of file on any platform and any device. Dropbox for Business never runs out of space. Each user starts off with 1 terabyte, and it's very easy to expand. Staff can collaborate with team members and securely invite and control access to outside partners, clients, and vendors. And most importantly, for IT professionals, you have control. Dropbox for Business has powerful admin controls like remote wipe, intuitive sharing, and permission controls, plus complete audit logs. This way, IT can make sure you get the right people having access to the sensitive company data. Dropbox for Business integrates with third-party security and administration solutions like SIEM, DLP, and eDiscovery for even more control. And last but not least, the robust Dropbox for Business infrastructure uses encryption for file data in transit and at rest, plus segmentation and hashing to anonymize files. Extra security features are available, like single sign-on and two-step verification. You want to give it a try? Take advantage of your employees' familiarity with Dropbox and sign up for Dropbox for Business. Visit dropbox.com/twit for a free 14-day trial of Dropbox for Business. That's dropbox.com/twit. Now on to a few more stories we're following today. The Next Web reports that Google has launched its first Apple Watch app. The most recent update to Google's news and weather app for iOS includes support for the Apple Watch. The app is really nothing special, but it does mean that Google won't be ignoring the platform that competes with Android Wear. May I suggest Gmail next? According to a press release from 9 to 5 Google today, CyanogenMD, the folks behind a more open source version of Android, received more investment, this time from Foxconn, the Chinese manufacturer known for being a very popular Apple supplier. Back in January, we reported that CyanogenMD also received an investment of $70 million from another company you might recognize called Microsoft. Calling all makers, just in time for the 10th annual Bay Area Maker Faire this weekend, Maker Media founder Dale Daugherty announced a new social network designed especially for makers. It's called Makerspace, and Roberto Baldwin over at Engadget says its mission is to take at-home tinkering and give it an online audience. Makerspace is still in beta, and you can sign up to be on the list until May 18th. For more details, you can go to makerspace.com. And finally, do you want to help defend Earth against asteroid threats? Like not in video games, but in real life, the Emergency Asteroid Defense Project, or EADP, is an NGO based in Copenhagen, Denmark. When they want your help, rather they want your money. They've started an Indiegogo crowdfunding project to raise money to support their project to develop an efficient and secure method of protecting the planet from disastrous asteroid impacts. These aren't just men in their mom's basement who've been playing asteroids since 1984. These are dedicated scientists, engineers, and experts working to design, construct, test, and ultimately implement small spacecraft that can deflect or disperse asteroids and comets with only a few days' warning. So check it out. A $9 donation will get you the peace of mind that you've protected all of us from our demise. And they will also give you a space cream sandwich. That's right, space cream. I have no idea what it is, but it's a special kind of ice cream, I guess, in space. Recently, I asked you to post your selfies watching Tech News Tonight, and we have had a great response. Today's TN2 selfie fan of the day is Andrew Green of Bridgman, Michigan. He sent us this photo with a Carrie picture on the wall behind him because yesterday, you remember, I was talking about the self-driving cars and said, does anyone remember the movie Christine? Andrew says, I realize Carrie is not Christine, but whatever, it's still Stephen King and the poster is up in here. Also, I am super serious while watching TN2 live. We can see that. Thanks, Andrew. I couldn't remember Christine at first either while I was writing the script. I kept thinking, Carrie. So thank you for the picture and the email. Send us more. Tag your pictures to hashtag TN2Selfie on Twitter, Google+, Instagram, or via email to tn2@twit.tv. Tell us a little bit about yourself, your favorite Stephen King books or movies, and we will show your selfie on the show. And that is it for this edition of Tech News Tonight. Subscribe to the show at twit.tv/tn2. Write to us at tn2@twit.tv and watch live every weekday at 4 p.m. Pacific. And don't miss our morning news program, Tech News Today, every weekday at 10 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Eastern. I'm Megan Maroney. Thanks for watching.
Bandwidth for Tech News Tonight is brought to you by CashFly.com.